This is Saturn V, the rocket that will send three Americans toward the moon in Project Apollo. But this historic journey cannot be attempted without knowledge. And so in 1961, the Gemini program came into being as the necessary prelude to Apollo. This is the story of Gemini and its legacy to spaceflight.
With one successful program under its belt, NASA had gained valuable experience in space. Project Mercury had shown to the world the United States were capable of sending people into space. But with the president promising the moon by the end of the decade, NASA still had a lot of ground and distance to cover. As with Mercury, astronauts on Gemini missions rode inside launch capsules mounted to rockets, which were built by McDonnell Aircraft Corporation and designed by Jim Chamberlain to carry two passengers, which is where the project took its name from. Gemini being Latin for twin. It was the first spacecraft to use a modular design with its components, meaning failing parts could easily be swapped out and replaced. It was also the first spacecraft to include an onboard computer, the Gemini Guidance Computer.
In the 18 months between March 1965 and November 1966, 10 manned missions were launched from Cape Kennedy.
Part of the Gemini team was Neil Armstrong, the first civilian astronaut, who would later make history with Buzz Aldrin and Michael Collins, also Gemini astronauts, when they became the first people to land on the moon. In order to do this, Project Gemini would need to develop the technology, invent new procedures, and train its personnel on how to make the trip and back. Having lost the race to put the first man into space, the US efforts to win a stage were once again thwarted when the Soviet Alexei Leonov became the first person to conduct a spacewalk on the 18th of March, 1965. It took the Gemini teams another 2.5 months to get their man out into space as part of the Gemini 4 team. These spacewalks were another milestone for the spacefaring nations, but there was a number of unforeseen problems associated with this new activity. Despite the low-gravity environment, astronauts on early Gemini spacewalks reported extreme exhaustion due to having to wear bulky and restrictive spacesuits for hours at a time. The breakthrough was made with astronaut Buzz Aldrin, who was put through underwater resistance training, similar to what is used when scuba diving, to build up the necessary muscle tone to enable successful spacewalks.
Although flight experience was the primary objective of Gemini, the program offered a unique space laboratory to science, medicine, and technology.
A return trip to the moon would require around 8 days in space, and so Gemini worked towards preparing its astronauts for this objective. In August 1965, the crew of Gemini 5 achieved this goal, which was surpassed only 2 months later by the crew of Gemini 7, who orbited the Earth for just under 2 weeks. But even before the long endurance flights, the Gemini missions focused on making sure that humans could survive the journey by running a number of scientific experiments during the missions. These looked at how space exploration affects basic human functions, such as sleeping or eating. NASA became concerned about the issue of consuming food in microgravity, particularly in the case of crumbs blocking or interfering with sensitive equipment, or even being inhaled by astronauts. This resulted in NASA pioneering the development of space food that was pressed into blocks or stuffed into tubes. Unfortunately, nutrition was prioritized over taste and appearance, so the eventual products were all of the same color, texture, and lacked any real flavor. One astronaut in particular was unimpressed with NASA's attempt at space cuisine, and on Gemini 3, John Young smuggled aboard a freshly made corned beef sandwich. The resulting pandemonium was perhaps predictable, as the sandwich fell apart in microgravity and sent crumbs everywhere, causing Young a lot of trouble back home with NASA officials and Congress. The incident of the corned beef sandwich did not seem to hinder his career very much, as he later became one of the few astronauts to walk on the moon. Just before Christmas in 1965, two Gemini craft, 6A and 7, succeeded in completing the first ever space rendezvous.
Gemini 6 approached within 1 foot of Gemini 7. Rendezvous, a major landmark in the history of manned flight.
With this maneuver completed, the two crafts disengaged and prepared for re-entry. But something caught the pilot's eye.
Gemini 6. We have an object, looks like a satellite, going from north to south, probably in a polar orbit.
Pilot had caught sight of an unknown object that was observed traveling below. He identified it as a red spacecraft, being pulled by 8 small objects. The punchline to this joke was later delivered with a rather scratchy rendition of Jingle Bells on the harmonica.
You're too much, Six.
Project Mercury proved that NASA can send a man into space. And Project Gemini gave them the tools to take the next step and send a team to the moon. Now all hope lay with Project Apollo.